Hello there. So, just today we have received our last campaigns and ranked seasons rewards. Now, up to the next campaign, Jagorax's due. I believe it will be against Eldari, yes, their laughing god of the Harlequins. It says we'll play as Dark Angels, Space Marines, and against Eldari. And in fact, I think a couple of Dark Angels units are actually fast. Why fast, you might ask? Because Thunderbolts Descent, next week's campaign reward, features keyword of fast. In this campaign, each fast units, usage of fast units, will give you extra 20% boost for receiving this common card. Dark Angels Nephilim Jet Fighter with an attack of 62 and 56 of initiative. This is a good card for Talmoran decks. And in fact, I will now feature you a 9 fast card bearing fast campaign exp gathering deck. 10, 14, 17, 19, 20 copies of of this card. This Nephilim Jet Fighter can be yours quite fast with this deck. Let me quickly show you. Ranked season is still in timer. So in casual mode, this is your all 9 fast units. I was actually quite dumbfounded to see Logan Grimnar himself was actually fast. This will be our warlord. He is the only fast warlord we can use, and due to the fact that his special rule is synergizes with the melee cards, most of the fast units in this deck is melee oriented. There are a couple more ranged units. This is like 161 point cost of deck, so you should use this deck up to 8, 9 or perhaps 10th level, depending on the duplicate cards of your collection and your level. Of course, you don't really need to use these 9 specific cards. Let me show you the other fast units. This is one of the other fast units, but it had ranged, thus I didn't want to include him. If we go below, there is another fast unit, however this is more ranged, thus I didn't include him. Also his scout boosts ranged over melee. Our scouts that I included in this deck boosts melee, not ranged. So yes, there are not much fast cards left. I tried to include all of them and they are here. Let's start. Logan Grimnar are our fast warlord. This brother Anuri is a Raven Guard veteran. He is fast. We will be able to win the initiative with this deck over the Eldari, which is quite fast on their own. A Dark Angels unit, brother Sergeant Midiel. He will be here. I think I will be managed to upgrade him to level 6 with this much copies. He is quite an early edition of our collections. Jetek Suberay, Deathwatch Space Marine Biker. He is, as you can see, as a rider biker, he is fast. His scout boost melee. A taunt unit with at level 6, at the 50th copy of your cards, your traits will become level 2 for the common cards. And this 42 melee attack Sanguinary Guard will actually quite a nice addition, a strong member of this deck. I don't have much copies of this Edric Setorax. I got one from the placement rewards of the On the Eve of Destruction campaign. 52 initiative, a Raven Guard fast unit, as you can see. And another fast unit of our deck, Skarin the Reaper. He's a cavalry, he's a rider. As you can see, all the riders, either bikers or those who ride on wolves, they are all fast. 54 initiative. Brother Nero, Primaris Outrider, once again a more melee oriented card. He will boost our melee with its scout trait. It will be unlocked. I have exactly two copies, just enough. And our wolf at the tier 2 scout is also a fast unit. He has no rider, but alone he is actually quite a good member for a mono attack type of cards. Mostly melee, 161 points. If you have 199 and say, Dorukhan, I want a 30 or 40 cost card and I want to sacrifice one of these cards here, perhaps if you don't have this much copies, Edric Setorax can be switched. Depending on your collection, once again, you can give a more card, a stronger card, and in that case, you will have 8 fast units. It's quite fast to collect Niv Nephilim Jet Fighter. In this deck, you have 9 fast cards. I won't be taking this deck to a casual match right now. I would rather would like to upgrade it first, then try to take it for a spin. Thank you for joining me. Have a nice day.